World War II. The first of them was the Yak 1.
One of mine.
This, though, is the Yak 3. It's a smaller and lighter version of the initial Yak 1, but this aircraft had, of course, still to be a very rugged and easy to maintain airframe for use in the colder climes of the Eastern Front. But it was also very, very agile, with high turn and roll rates particularly, and the Yak 3 proved itself more than a match for contemporary German fighters, the likes of the Messerschmitt Bf 109G and the Focke Wulf Fw 190. In the Battle of Kursk, from July to August 1943, so 75 years ago this year, Yak 3s really won their spurs and were part of Soviet efforts during that battle to really gain the upper hand against German forces. These were the first major combats for the Yak 3, and they immediately proved their worth. Is that the Luftwaffe supposedly gave orders to their fighter pilots not to engage the Soviet Yaks in lower level dogfights. Those stories in truth are probably apocryphal. But nonetheless, the Yak 3 was used primarily as a low level fighter rather than as a bomber escort. The Soviets used other types for that, the likes of the Bell P-39 era Cobra. So the homegrown design for Lvovkin LA 5 and 7 and Yakovlev Yak 9. But as a defence fighter, because it was relatively short range, the Yak 3 was very effective, and in summer 1944, deliveries really started to gear up. One squadron in particular cemented the legend of these aircraft, the so-called Normandie-Niemen squadron, which was Regiment de Chasse 3 of the Free French. That squadron had been set up in 1942 in the wake of the German invasion of the Soviet Union. It was an effort to increase ties between the Free French under General Charles de Gaulle and the Soviets. Originally, it was named simply Normandie, but that was later changed to reflect the unit's role in efforts to liberate areas around the Niemen River in the then USSR. They flew Yak 7s and Yak 9s before they converted to the Yak 3. And the last 99 of that regiment's 273 confirmed aerial kills were scored in the Yak 3s. Pilots in their Soviet aircraft returned to France after V-Day in June 1945, and they arrived at Le Bourget Airport in Paris. There's some footage of their arrival indeed that can be found online. The aircraft were in effect gifted to the French pilots after the war. This was the cause of some disagreement with the authorities at that time. And this aircraft, which is a more modern reproduction of a Yak 3, today carries the markings of the Normandie-Niemen Regiment. More than 4,800 aircraft formed the original Yak 3 production run, In the early 1990s, the Yakovlev company announced that it was going to build a small new run of these aircraft to satisfy demand from the Western warbird scene. They chose the Allison V-1710 engine instead of the original Klimov VK-105. The two units developing similar horsepower and both giving the aircraft a maximum speed somewhere in the region of 350 knots or 400 miles an hour. There were other Yak 3 new production runs arranged around that time in the USA and in Romania, and it proved very popular as a relatively affordable warbird fighter. This one built at the Yakovlev plant in Orenburg during the 1990s. It's in two-seat configuration with dual controls. Filled an important gap in helping us to remember the exploits of the Soviet air forces during World War II. This one came to Germany for operation as part of the Meyer Motors fleet at first Freiburg and then Remgarten in southern Germany. In 2014, though, it was bought by its current owner, Will Greenwood. As part of the Great War display team. He was on the lookout for a warbird fighter, and the Yak 3 fitted the bill very well indeed. Setting up now for a final flypast from left to right. This is Will Greenwood with the Yakovlev Yak 3. Very nice to see that aircraft at East Kirkby for the first time. Will base it at Goodwood in West Sussex.